You are selfish. All of you are selfish machines. You are selfish machines doomed to obey. This is the main idea of a young scientist that in 1976 wrote a book called The Selfish Gene. Till then, the main theory was written by Darwin in his book The Descent of the Man in Relation to Sex, in which he said that the main fundamental unit of evolution is the species or group. But Richard Dawkins said the contrary, that the main important thing is the gene. So we are all machines that do what our genes want us to do. We are survival machines. We are automatons. With this in mind, he resolved the ancient dilemma, which came first, the egg or the hen. The answer was, the hen is the means, the vessel, the container by which the genes get reproduced. The genes gave order to us to behave as they want to behave in order to have a better performance in the environment, to strive to survive among the other species and the other genes, because they compete at genetic level. This theory encountered some problems, because they had to explain if there is altruism. If we are in our inner self selfish, how can you explain many sources of altruism? Altruism is the disinterested and self concerns about other for the well-being of others. And Richard Dawkins said on this that you are altruistic or selfish depending on the environment that your genes are immersed, and they behave depending on that behavior, increase or decrease the chances of survival. Is there altruism? Yes, there is. There is altruism, like the eusocial animal, like these ants. A bee can sting you and after die because they are not prepared for stinging. This is an example of intra-species example that Dawkins resolved. But there are many others, like this example in 2012, that a pod of humpback whales saved a calf baby whale from a pod of orcas that was chasing him at this moment. But there are also intra-species examples, like the gorilla, the female gorilla in the Brookfield Zoo, that saved a toddler that fell into the cage and dragging to the cuidador. And an amazing one, a surfer, Todd Entwistle, that in 2007 was surrounded by a pod of dolphins that fight back a shark that attacked him and drove him to the shore. But the most amazing one is this. You know that I love cats.
Oh no.
Last May, a cat called a tabby cat saved a toddler. It was the family pet, from the attack of the dog. I have the video, but I will try to show you afterwards, because I don't know if I have enough time. the cat saved the child. Is the video? Well, Richard Dawkins said, if there is such a cases in the nature, how can you explain that? You explain that because we are made up not only of genes, but also from memes. An acronym that means a meme in relation to a gene that is a minimum genetic unit. A meme is the minimum transmission unit of cultural inheritance. Anything that you can learn or behave learning from others. A meme is something that you can get from any film, from any book, from any idea. We are our choices. As we are both made of genes and memes, we have a genetic selfish nature, but also an individual macromolecular, an individual emotional nature. I've been investigating this in this very room, trying to discover what meme do we have here. There is a new species, the Toastmaster Solitary Egoistus. This meme makes you believe that it is that if you don't participate, you deprive others for a selfish motive to learn. Please, be selfish. As a storyteller said, storytellers make us think to help others. Liars make us think to help themselves. Thank you.